Hello, hi friends. Now, this video is based on the process of elimination of a toxicant from the biological organisms. Now, in the previous video, we have seen that how the toxicants can enter the body. So, there are four routes we have seen. That is inhalation, injection, ingestion, dermal absorption. Now, all other four routes are there for entry of that toxicant material into the body. Now, we can see what is how they are eliminated. Now, the organs in the body which are responsible for elimination are generally kidney, lung and livers, then when skin, all these things are nothing but the organs which will eliminate the toxicant. Unwanted material can be eliminated from these organs. So very first process for elimination is excretion. Now this is nothing but a general and natural process where the unwanted compounds that are present in the body, it can be eliminated through kidney, liver, lungs and other organs. So that is a natural process. Now second process is also a natural process, that is a detoxification. Now what happens here, it is not excreting anything, or it is not what will happen here, it is changing. Now whatever the material is there in the body, by a bio transformation it can be converted into a very less harmful material. So that is the second part, second process. Then the third process is storage. Now whatever the unwanted materials that are present in the body can be converted into a fatty acids. So that is the natural processes that occurs in the body. So these are the three methods from where the toxic material can eliminated from the body. So now we see how it works. So in kidney, what happens there? Now from the notes itself, you can see I have underlined that how it is the kidney works. Now we can see that here, you can see here kidneys are generally made up for excretion of a human body. So we can see that it eliminates the whatever the substance are there. It is entered through ingestion process, inhalation process, injection process and dermal absorption process. Now toxicants are, what happens there, toxicants are extracted by the kidneys from the bloodstream and excreted in the urine. So this is the work of, this is the natural process that happens in our body. Now the second process is that again there is some problem in that. So we talk toxicant that are ingested. So whatever the toxicant are ingested into the digestive tract are generally excreted by the liver. So there are two types of excretion in the liver. First one, when the higher molecular compounds are there, generally about around 300, so they are converted into bile and it can be excreted by the liver. The less molecular weight compounds are generally eliminated by the kidneys. Now one more process is there, you can see here the digestive tracts. Again there is a digestive tract in the body which will detoxify the agents. Whatever the agents that are entered into the body, it will detoxify. What it detoxify, it will convert that chemical into a very less harmful compound. So that is the process. Now again one more the elimination process or the organ is lung. Now lungs can eliminate. Lungs are means for elimination of a substance. So particular those are volatile. Now we can see that examples are there, chloroform and ethanol can be excreted by this route. Again another process, another route is that excretion are by the skin. So whatever the sweats are there, we are coming from the skin, it is nothing but the elimination process. Again there is another route by hair, by the nails. So these are the elimination process that happens in the body. Now, what why we are studying this? Because what happens? These are the natural process. Body itself eliminated all the toxicant, or we can say unwanted material that are not that is important for a body. But how it will affect? So in the next part of this, we will see how, at what concentration, at what quantity, at what quality, if the that toxic material or the chemical if entered into the body, so how it will affect, what are the diseases, what are the diseases will be taking place. So that we have to study. Now the third step of toxicology, in the previous lecture itself we have studied. See, it is the effects. So these are the effects. Now we can say how the effect, how this chemical affect the body. So we can see that various effects are there. Now generally, broadly, it is the effects are classified according to the nature. Now we can say that it is the effects may be irreversible, it may be reversible. Now what is reversible and irreversible? Irreversible are the diseases where the disease cannot be cured easily by medication. So it is a permanent one. Once it happens, it may remain for lifetime. We can see that in irreversible there is a carcinogen. So these are the carcinogens are nothing but toxic which can cause cancer. The second one is the mutagen, then it causes the chromosome damages. Then reproductive hazards causes damage to the reproductive system. Then teratogen causes birth defects. Then effects that are reversible, that means it may be cured by medication. So we can see that it is classified as dermatotoxic, it will affect the skin. Hematotoxic, it will affect the blood. Hepatotoxic, it will affect the liver. Nephrotoxic, affect the kidneys. Neurotoxic, affect nervous system. Pulmonotoxic, affect lungs. So these are the effect. So that is the third part of a toxicology study. First one we have studied the interlude, second one we have studied elimination, third one we are studying here, we are seeing is the effect, how that chemical will affect the body, or that is body or a biological organism. So these are the major part for studying a toxicology.